In this video, I'm going to teach you how to create wavy text like shown in After Effects. Start by creating a new composition. Call it text. And then under presets, select Social Media Portrait HD 30 FPS. Check duration is 10 seconds and change background color to white. And then press OK. If your composition comes up as transparent, simply untoggle transparency grid as shown, just like that. Next, click on the text tool and create your text. I'm using Times New Roman regular at size 82. Now use the align tool to center your text horizontally and vertically as shown. If you can't see the align tool, simply go up to Windows and click on align. Now we'll turn on the grid. Following on, select the region of interest tool, which is this one here. And we're going to want to zoom in. We'll zoom into around maybe about, let's say, 100%. And now we're going to select our region of interest. So we'll go to about here, there. And about halfway here. And if you want to move anything, just click and move it in or out as needed. And you can always zoom in further for greater accuracy. Something like that. Now go to composition. And click Trim Comp to Region of Interest. Next, create a new composition. So click on Composition and New Composition. And you can just keep it as Comp 1 and you can keep all the settings the same as before. And we'll click OK. Now you may want to zoom out again. We'll go to Fit, just like that. And now we can turn off our grid. We'll click on Choose Grid and Guide Options, and we'll turn off the grid. And next, we're going to want to drag the text composition into our new comp. Now go over to Effects and Presets, which is down here. And we're going to want to search for the Motion Tile effect. And we'll double click to add this to our text layer. And under the motion tile effect, we'll change the output width to about 780 and output height to about 2640. And then I'm just going to put down the tile height a wee bit. We'll make the tile height about 89. Now all our text fits nicely within our composition. Nice. So now we're going to add some keyframes to the tile center. So we'll go to the start of our composition and we'll add a keyframe and we'll go right to the end and we're just going to change the X axis and we'll change that to 1695. I'll press enter. So now if we play this back, we'll see the text goes from left to right and left to right. Excellent. Now next, we're going to add another effect to this text layer. We'll go to Effects and Presets and we'll search for Wave Warp. We'll double click to apply. And under Wave Warp, we're going to change the wave height to 16, the wave width to 170, and we're going to change the direction to 120, and the wave speed we're going to change to 0. And we'll keep everything else the same. So now if we play this, we'll see we've got some nice wavy movement. So now we'll create a new white solid layer by clicking Control Y, and we'll call it white. And then we'll go into the color and we'll change it to white. And we'll press OK, and we'll press OK again. And we're going to move this white solid layer below the text layer. And we can hide the text keyframes as we won't need them. Then create a new adjustment layer by going up to Layer, New, Adjustment Layer. And make sure the adjustment layer is between the white solid and the text layer. If it isn't, you can just move it as shown. Now go to Effects and Presets and search for Hue/Saturation. And we'll double click to apply that to the adjustment layer 1. Okay. And under the Hue Saturation effect, we're going to change the master saturation to minus 50. And we're going to change the master lightness to minus 20. And that's it. Then search for noise under effects and presets. So noise. And double click to apply. And move the noise effect above the hue/saturation effect. Just like this. And increase the noise amount to your desired amount. I like to set it about 21%. And press OK. Excellent. So now we're going to create a new adjustment layer. We're going up to Layer, New, and Adjustment Layer. And make sure this adjustment layer is on top of all your other layers. And under Effects and Presets, search for Fill. And double click to apply. And we're going to change the fill color to black. And we'll press OK. Now make sure you have the adjustment layer 2 highlighted, and then we'll click on the rectangle tool and we're going to create 2 masks like shown. Something like this. So that's one, and then we'll create another. You're going to want to make sure the masks go just a wee bit outside your composition, just to make this effect look a bit better. And under each mask, we're going to change the feather amount to about 430, and we'll change the opacity to 70. And then we'll go into mask 2, we'll do the same, 430, and change the opacity to about 70. That's the animation done, actually. Now let's look back at what we made.